first of all, guys, great to see you.
Nice to see you.
And really good to see you back on the big screen, I've got to say. How was it coming back to the Inbetweener series?
We just slotted right back in. It was great. It had been 3 years since the first film. And I think this was the most fun we've ever had doing the Inbetweeners. Almost because we just had like 3 years worth of jokes lined up, backed up, ready to go. And also because Ian and Damon, who are the writers for this film, stepped up to being directors as well. So usually we have an external director come in, sort of somebody with authority who we're a bit scared of. Whereas on this film, we didn't have that. So we were in charge.
Ian and Damon directed it, which we treated as a kind of sort of a joke.
Which they really appreciated, didn't they?
Oh, they loved it.
Really helped them get the confidence they needed.
Not really treating them like the directors.
We treated them like competition winners for the whole this film.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, God, you're doing well, aren't you?
Oh, do you want to be a director when you're older? You'd be really good at it.
They didn't like this at all.
When we're done, you can say cunt.
She looks well freaked out.
Do you think that might have anything to do with the car?
Doubt it.
This is the classic Aussie shagging wagon.
The mobile virgin conversion unit.
Well, it sounds like it was great fun to shoot. Is there any particular scenes that were really good laughter to do?
I think generally any time that we're in the car is really good fun because we're kind of isolated from everyone else, but they have headphones on, so we've got an audience. We know that we can be heard, but no one can really get to us. And also, we're in charge of like the clapperboard and stuff, so we can scrub off like Ian's name and put in like, you know, the name of a fat person that we would compare him to,
Pavarotti
would be a good example, or his nickname on set, Sam Allardyce is good, or David Moyes because he's taken a successful franchise and who knows what's gonna happen. So David Moyes is a good one. Just that in the car is great because we just we can kind of just. Feels like we can kind of do what we want and we're a little bit untouchable, which is great fun for us.
What would you say is the funniest thing that sort of happened while you're filming? Is there any like really good banter behind the scenes or anything?
Well, I don't know really.
Other than the car stuff that we've mentioned, but me and Joe did a meat challenge at a restaurant where we had to basically eat a kilogram of steak, a whole rack of ribs, kilogram of fries and salad. And basically, it just both made us really, really ill, as you would expect.
It was genuinely unpleasant.
It wasn't funny for them.
It wasn't a nice.
We loved it.
The crowd totally turned.
Joe was giving it all the big one to begin with. Yeah.
I was
so these guys were slagging him off, and then I actually started doing really, really well. And
it looked like you were going to do it.
It looked like I was going to do it, so I thought, I've nailed this. I've absolutely smashed it.
It was down to the last few fries.
I'm going
to
take the mick out of Joe and just wipe him up.
To make fun of Joe.
And then my belly caught up with me and realised what I'd put in it. And
the evening ended. I was so sick when I got back to my hotel room that I was worried about the size of the lumps that were coming up.
It was chunky.
I was literally like, that can't come up. Because that's too big. That feels like it's about that size. That can't come up through my esophagus because it's going to kill me. I was in the bathroom in my hotel literally going, weeping with pain.
Okay, so finally, I'd just like to say, is there going to be an Inbetweeners 3? I know everyone's really going to want there to be.
Basically, the writers have said they've not really got any other ideas.
Once they see the film, there's quite a feeling that this will be the end. It's just such a big...
You don't die, do you? Or something? Is that what
you're hearing?
There's such a big, epic feel to this film. Straight from the beginning, like, you know, the opening credits are very sort of cinematic, and which is funny in itself because the Inbetweeners shouldn't be doing something so slick and sort of impressive. So that in itself is a joke, but there's no way we can top this, ever. And we won't ever agree to doing something that we feel is a step backwards, or because that's why we put off doing it for so long, because we just didn't think that there was a good enough idea to do until they came up with this one, and it was just we ran out of reasons why not to do it then.